So we will definitely take the concept from the human body only. Okay. So if that is understood, then definitely you will understand plants and other animals. Okay. So what you have to see that when we talk about humans, okay, and all humans, okay, irrespective of their gender, male, female, irrespective of their age, young, adults, old, anything you can take the criteria, okay, and from any of the geographical zone, no matter it is from he is from America or Indian or African or any tribal location, okay. So all humans on the earth, wherever they are found, to make a human, you require 23 pair of chromosomes. That is a compulsory rule. Now see, if it becomes 24 pair, then it also not a human. If it becomes 22 pair, then also he is not a, that particular individual is not a human. It, this is the thing, and it should not be changed at any cost. Then only the individual which is formed is going to be a human. Okay, that is compulsory rule. Now see this, that if we take the parent, we require parents, pair of parents, and one should be male, one should be female. That is also a natural thing to understand, that if we talk about parents, that will definitely one should be a father and another should be a mother. Okay. Now, both of them will be having 23 pair of chromosomes. Both of them will be having this. Do you understand this?
Yes, yes, ma'am.
Yes.
Okay. Yeah, okay, fine. I will be a bit slower right now just to make you understand how the genetics should be learned. Okay. So last class we did something about characters and traits. We did learn this. Okay, so let's see this, that character can be a height and traits can be of two types, either tall or short. That means height can have the two types of variations. Either the individual can be a tall, or it, that individual can be a short. This much is clear to you?
Yes,
ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Now see, for each and every character in your body, the texture of your skin, the color of your skin, the texture of your hairs, the way your hair looks, the way your eye color looks, everything, every inch of your body is just decided by these 23 pairs of chromosomes. Okay. This particular human, how does he look? It is all up to this. Okay. And this mother, how she will look? That is all completely depends on the 23 pairs belongs to her. Okay. So let's see that if we talk about this particular character in a human. Now suppose, do understand this, that we talk in a general population that basically males are always taller in comparison to the females. Okay, that is a general population outlook. That we are not talking about exceptions right now. Okay, so male is generally a taller and females are a bit shorter than the male. Okay, so see this, that for the character height, one pair of chromosome is responsible to give that particular character. Okay, so that one particular pair of chromosome, I'm talking about pair. So let's say like this. Okay, pair of chromosome, basically it should be genes. We should not take the whole chromosome, but right now you understand this, that this height, tallness in the father, okay, it is coming from the pair of chromosomes. Is it clear to you?
Ma'am, why you have taken TT?
That is what I'm saying. When we you are talking about a character, it should be present in the chromosomes. Are you getting me?
Okay, ma'am.
See, understand this. That chromosomes are nothing but the DNA. Okay, chromosomes are nothing but the DNA, and chromosomes consist of genes. Now see, this is the structure of chromosome, and you have lot of genes on them. Is it clear to you?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, this is a structure of chromosome, and you have numerous number of genes present on them. So we know that there should be pair of chromosomes present in the human. Okay, so if this is the one pair, it consists of genes in them, and if this is called one pair, see, one gene of tallness should be here and one gene of tallness should be here. That is why I took T and T. Is it clear to you now?
Yes, ma'am. Now it is clear. Thank you, ma'am.
Now it is clear? Okay, fine. So that is how it works. We talk about the pair of genes right now. Any character, if I take a skin color, that suppose if I take black, okay, so B and B, because black is a pure color, so I will take two capital B's over here, and if one B is present here, then definitely other one will be present here only with the pair. Now it is clear to you?
Yes, ma'am.
Fine. So that is why I took,
yes, ma'am,
two T's for this. Okay. And this one, we are talking about a father right now. For whom we are talking is the father. Because father is tall, clear height is seen. So we will take a gene for the tallness, and it should be in pairs in the father. Understood?
Yes, ma'am.
Fine. So similarly, we go for a mother. Because mother is short, okay, so it will be denoted by these signs. Okay? Small t. She must, she definitely, she is a mother. She will be having two pairs of chromosomes in her. Out of 23, one pair of chromosome will be definitely having the gene for the tallness. And here, if it is that small t is there, then definitely another t will be here. Now it is clear to you?
Ma'am, what does small t denote?
A shortness.
Okay, ma'am.
Okay, Now, let's see why I am taking capital T and small t with respect to the tall and shortness. That in environment, we take two types of traits. If we talk about traits, then suppose if I talk about in the population tall and short, this is a general difference that we can see in the height. So when we talk about traits, that in a population, we can say that tallness is a dominating character. You can see a lot of tall people. Okay. So the population is, suppose if you take a study of 100 individual, tall people will be comparatively having the more population on earth as compared to the short. So tallness is a dominating feature of a population or a character of a population. Do you understand this?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay.
Yes, ma'am.
And shortness, in biology, we say it's a recessive one. It is same, but if we take the whole population of the earth, the short people are comparatively lesser as compared to the tall people. That is why tallness is considered as a dominating feature, dominant one, while this one is recessive, which is comparatively lesser in the population. So tallness has to be denoted with pure G pair of genes, T and T, capital T, while shortness is also a pure pair of recessive genes. Okay, pure pairs of recessive genes. If a person is having two pairs of genes, small t are there, then definitely that individual will be shorter in height. Is this clear to you?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. You don't have to go in lot of thinking that why it is in the middle, what is happening, nothing. Just stick to the concept right now, what we are getting for these two pure traits. Understood?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Once you are thorough with this, then definitely you are going to understand what happens when for the person with who is in the mediocre height. Okay. So this is what you have to understand. Now see, when we talk about gametes, for male, sperms are formed, and for females, eggs are formed. Is it true?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Sperms are formed for males and eggs are formed for females, or ova, whatever you say. Okay, eggs or ova. Now see this. Whenever gametes are formed from father, out of one pair of chromosome, that means out of two chromosome, only one chromosome goes to the sperm. Got it?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. That means this particular sperm is receiving only one T. That is understood?
Yes, ma'am. Out of two pairs, only one pair is receiving.
Yes. Only one pair goes to this particular sperm. Now, why it is happening, that will also you will understand. Just do understand that out of two, only that means from one pair, only one chromosome enters in the DNA of the sperm, not both of them. Okay. Similarly with the ova, because for what we are talking about right now, gametes. Do understand this. And gametes are responsible for reproduction. That's why. So, and from mother, this particular ova is also receiving only one chromosome out of one pair. So, let's write small t. Now it is clear to you?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So, now what is happening? When the sperm and ova fertilize or fuses, okay, when this fertilizes or fuses, then zygote is formed. And this zygote will receive one chromosome from father and one chromosome from mother. Okay, that means capital T from father and small t from mother. That means this individual, this baby, when it will develop or it will mature, it will have a combination of this. Have you understood this?
Ma'am, only one pair will have now, T and one, small t.
Yes. One pair out of one, two chromosomes, similar type of chromosomes are present. Okay. So, because both of them are completely similar, only one will be received by sperm. Here also both of them are completely similar. That's why they are called one pair. They are copy of each other. Got it?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Both of them are copy of each other. So no need to receive two copies. Only one has to be received over in the gametes. This is clear to you?
Two pairs are the same in males and females both now.
Pardon? Can you repeat?
Ma'am, 22 pairs are same in males and females. Only the
24. Don't go there. Don't go there. You are thinking about XY and XX. Don't think about that right now. Okay? Don't think about that. Just think right now 23 pairs. Nothing else. Okay? So, this is what is happening. Now, do understand. If you get both the pairs from father, both the pairs from the mother, then what you will, the zygote will receive? Then it will become T, T, T and T. If you get both the pairs, then this will be the combination.
Then the chromosomes will also be 46.
Yes.
Then 46
pairs will become, and then definitely that zygote will not be a human.
Yes, ma'am.
Have you understood this concept now?
Yes, ma'am.
Why we are getting only one of the gene only? Okay, that is what is the compulsory rule from father. Because see, whenever we talk about one pair, both of them are a copy of each other. Okay, we have 23 pairs and 23 pairs are present in form of copy of each other. So out of 23 pair, that means 46 chromosomes, you can pick 23 to form a gamete. Is it clear to you?
Yes, ma'am.
Fine. Everybody?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, girls? She is not clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, fine. So, that is why we don't require both the pairs to be received from the parents. Only one will do to form a human baby. Now, if this is clear to you, then definitely we will go for the Mendel's experiment.
Yes, ma'am, clear.
You just take your time to understand. If still you have doubt, do ask me.
Yes, ma'am, understood.
Understood? Ma'am. Fine. Yes.
Ma'am, the zygote has both the pairs. Means
one from father, one from mother.
Yes, ma'am. Then what will it doesn't have a copy of both of them. What will it become then? Tall or short?
Okay, fine. So that is what we will see when we do the Mendel genetics. Okay?
Okay, ma'am.
Fine? Fine. So let's see. That is what you have to understand for the Mendel genetics, for the pea plant. I know you must be having that if both one is capital and one is small, then the person will be, what will happen to his height? Okay, that is what you are asking.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, so see, that is what, once we do this Mendel, then you will understand. So Mendel took pea plant. Pea plant, and he took out of all the characters, he took 7 characters to be studied for his experiment. Okay, now suppose if you take one of your friend to be studied, okay, if you want to study your best friend, then you can't go for all the characters present in his body. What you will take? Only the main features like eyes, which you can differentiate easily, skin color you can differentiate easily, the way the hair looks, curly or straight or something like that. Then you that character you can take. Then you can see the height, you can see the activeness, immunity of the body. The one which you can observe, the one which you can see through your visible eyes, only though that much characters can be studied easily. So Mendel took only 7 characters of the pea plant which were studied thoroughly. I think in the last class I must have explained you that shape of pea seeds, height of pea plant, color of the flower, all these characters he took. Okay, so for you, you don't have to remember the 7 characters. Just he took some of these characters, and out of these characters, first character that was to be studied by him was height of pea plant. If this is one character, then definitely it will have 2 types of traits. That is tall and short plants. Is it clear to you?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So here also, what he did was he took male pea plants and female pea plants. All tall male plants and all short female plants. Because Mendel also did all this in very ancient time, and it was technology was very much limited. So he also took the general observation from the population that tallness is basically in the males and shortness is basically in the females. Then let's go for this study. Okay. So he took all the tall plants as a male and all the short plants as a female. Shall I proceed then?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So definitely, if this pea plant is tall, it will be also having pair of genes responsible for the tallness.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. And it will be having a pair of genes responsible for the shortness. Okay. This type of condition we say that it is a pure, these plants are pure genetic characteristics. That means no mixture of genes is there. Pure shortness, pure tallness can be seen. Now see, when Mendel did this, he was not.
Ma'am, we can also tell this homozygous or homozygote.
Yes, homozygous condition. That is true.
Is it compulsory that the father plant is always tall and mother plant is always short?
See, it is not compulsory, dear. But what happened that in generally he took the observation from the population that male are always tall. That is why Mendel did this. Understood this?
Yes, ma'am.
You can, if you are doing experiment on a pea plant, you can reverse this. Okay, you can take the female plants who are tall and select a male plant which are short. You can do that. You can reverse this experiment. Got it? But what the Mendel did, that is what we are learning. Understood?
Yes, ma'am.
Fine. So, if this is a plant, okay, so definitely a male plant is going to bear pollens, okay, gametes. If we say for the plants, male will have pollens and ovules in the females. Is this part is clear to you?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, that I think you are aware that male pollens are the behaving as a male reproductive factor and ovules are behaving as a female reproductive factor. Okay, so let's see. When pollens were formed, definitely, because they are gametes, definitely they will receive only one T out of this.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, so it received only one T and ovules received only one small T. Is it clear to you?
Ma'am, can you repeat once again?
See, these pollens and ovules are what?
Gametes.
Gametes. Okay, so whenever the gametes are formed, they are definitely going for reproduction. And because they are responsible for the reproduction, they should receive the gene from the parent. And all the pollens, n number of pollens are formed. All the pollens received only this particular form of gene because this is what is available with the father. Is it clear to you?
Okay, ma'am.
Okay, fine. So this is done, and because this particular generation of parent, we will denote it by P. Okay, so when these types of gametes, or well, let's say when these types of pollens and ovules got fused or fertilized with each other, then the new plant was formed with the combination of T, T. You got this?
Ma'am, just like the previous case.
Yes, just like humans, this is what happened with the pea plant also. They got the combination of T and T. Now see, this was first generation he obtained from the parent. Okay, now understand this part very clear. There are not only one pollen and one ovule. They are 100 in numbers. Okay, he took not only one plant. He took the whole field, whole garden for it. And all the plants got this combination. But now see, Mendel cannot see the DNA at that time. So what he was observing was only the character which can, with trait which can be seen through naked eye. So what happened that the whole field was filled with tall plants. That means if you receive capital T and small t out of this, the one which expresses itself. Okay, let me write this capital T and small t. The one which expresses itself, it expresses the character itself clearly. That is why it is called.
Ma'am, the right side is not, cannot be seen.
No. See? So, a capital T, because this gene can express itself completely. And that is why it is called dominant. And this T will not allow the trait of this T or the feature of this T to appear in the population. That's why this small t is called recessive. Is this clear to you?
What is the meaning of recession?
Recessive, that means which cannot express itself or which is not able to show its character, which is not able to show its feature in the population. That is why small t was considered as a recessive. Now see, when this small t is present along with the capital T, then it was recessive. It was not able to express, it was not able to make the plant short. Okay, because this gene worked out 100, more than 100 means 100% efforts, and all the plants were tall, because in all the plants only this particular gene showed his presence, his feature, his character. But if this T is present in this form, that means both the T's are small, then no other option is there. They are going to express themselves. Okay, that's why mother was short. But here what happened, because option is there with the plant that either it can be a tall or it can be a short. But so the tallness, because it was a dominating feature by the gene tried to express the one which was with the capital T or the dominant factor. Is it clear to you?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So, now you have understood that if you are brother and sister.
Small t will show its other characters now.
Fine. Can you repeat, please?
Ma'am, but the small t will show its other characters now.
Which other characters, beta? It is responsible only for the shortness, not any other thing in the organism. This particular gene is responsible only for the shortness. The type of height it can express is only shortness. It will not show you the color, it will not show you the texture or something like that. It is that particular gene is responsible only for the shortness. Okay.
Then what is the use of the female plant?
That will come definitely for reproduction. Male and female both are required, and it is compulsory rule. If you don't have a mother, then the zygote will receive only one T, and definitely if this is happening in the human, suppose if mother is not there, then what will happen? You will receive only 23 chromosomes. Then can you be a human?
No, ma'am.
No, we require both of them. Okay, we require both of them, both the parents, to be a particular complete individual. Okay, don't feel so bad about why the females are taking to shore. Don't feel that. Okay, because this will also come with its result when we go further. Okay, so see this. So, what happened with the Mendel, that the whole generation he obtained from the parent was tall. That means if suppose he got 100 plants here in this generation, all the 100 plants were taught. Is it clear to you?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Now,
so it is compulsory that all plants will be male only.
No, that is not the rule. I didn't mention the gender over here. Okay. That is not. See, if I talk about tall, that is not compulsory that tall, that means only male. It is not the thing. See, when the parents' gametes are fusing, here, the baby which is formed, tall T and small t is received by from father and mother. This baby is what you will say, he that particular individual is going to be a boy only because it received a capital T. Because it received a capital T, it will not decide the sex of the zygote. Understood?
Yes, ma'am. It will only
depend on the character of the.
Yes.
Ma'am, is it necessary to have same kind of T for a parent?
No, it is not necessary. Because definitely in future, this type of individual is going to be a parent. Do you understand this?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, so that is not a rule. But to understand genetics, how it is working, that is why we are taking this type of flowchart. Clear?
Ma'am, if both the parents are sorted, then?
Then definitely you will come with all these perspective once you are thorough with this. You can do this flowchart, this combination with on for yourself also. Suppose you have a parent or you have a friend whose parents are short. Okay. So you can have that combination also in your books. You can do, you can find out the genetic combination present in him. That you can also do. Just do understand how it can be done. Got it?
Yes.
Okay. Yeah, I will come to your query that if what happened if both the parents are short, that will also we will see. Okay. So right now do understand that.
Ma'am, what is F1, F2?
That is first generation. You go for right now first generation, second generation, because the one which I use filial and all that, that will come in 11th and 12th. Once you go there, then you will understand what does that mean. So just understand right now F1, first generation. Okay. Shall I proceed then?
Yes, ma'am.
Fine. So this generation received all the tall plants. Now what Mendel did was, see what I'm saying. This is not deciding the sex of the plant. He received tall plants. Now, see, out of 100, there may be the possibility that 50 plants can be a male and 50 can be a female. Is it clear to you? Out of 100 plants he received, 50 can be a male and 50 can be a female. Is this clear to you?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So, see, here we are talking only about height. So, you don't have to worry about the sex of the zygote which is formed. Okay. What will happen to a boy or what will happen to a girl? You don't have to worry about. When we will talk about the sexes, then you have a different set of chromosomes for them. Okay. So right now what we are seeing is only height. So out of 100, 50 can be a male, 50 can be a female. So these male which were formed, they got this combination. And females formed, they also got this type of combination. Is this clear to you?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. No matter it's a male or a female, both of them received the same combination of genes for the character that is called height. Now it is clear to you?
Yes, sir.
Fine. So let's proceed. What he did was, Mendel, that he allowed the fertilization between this generation. Okay? So, he allowed the fertilization between these types of plants. Now, when they have to be fertilized, they definitely, if these are the whole individual, whole plants, then this will also form pollens. And this will form ovules.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Now, suppose 100 pollens are produced by this plant. Out of 100, 50 were capital T and 50 were small t. Got me what I'm saying?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, because only one copy has to be received. So 50 received this and 50 received this, 50%. And here also, the ovules which are formed, they were of two type. Now it is clear to you?
Yes.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So fine. If this is done, then what happened that when these types of pollens, fused with these types of ovules, okay, then what happened that we got the combination that is again, can you see this? One from yes, father and yes, one ma'am. From mother, but still both of them are capital T. Can you do, are you getting me or you are understanding yes, me what is happening over here?
Yes, ma'am.
Fine, yes. Now, if these types of pollens were fused with this type of capital T, ovules, then what happened is the new plant which was formed received pollen, that is male character from a father and female character from the mother. Okay. Now, again, let's proceed for this. If these types of pollen fuse with these types of pollens. Okay. So what is happening? It received a small t from father and capital T from mother. Got it?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, fine. And if these types of pollens fuse with these types of ovules, then the generation which was formed received small t from father and small t from mother. Now you can see the thing, or you can see the how the juggling of the genes is happening.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, so this was the second generation he obtained from that particular plant. Now, for these type of generation, these are the parents. Okay, and for these types of plants, these were the parents. Now you got me? It is not compulsory that father should be always capital T or father, mother should be always small t. This should not be the rule. there may be this possibility also. Have you understood this?
Ma'am?
Yes?
That's why the people who are having sisters or brothers have variations in their height.
Yes, that is what I am saying. That if you are having a siblings, okay, you can see in your home or neighborhood that having 4-5 brother and sisters must be there, and all of them are showing a different kind of height. There may be the possibility their sisters are taller as compared to the brother. There may be the possibility that some brothers are tall and some brothers are shorter. There may be this possibility also. Understood?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, so it all depends on what type of combination of gene is obtained by that particular individual. Now, here see, these babies, these plants which were formed, okay, pea plant which were formed. Here we are not mentioning male or female. We are just saying that these types of plants were formed. Now, suppose there may be the possibility that Mendel must have got thousands of plants, 1,000 plants after this fertilization, okay? And he got 1,000 plants, and from 1,000, let's suppose if 250 are here, 250 of this combination, 250 here, 250 here. He got this type of number genetically. There may be the possibility that out of 250, 200 are male and 50 are female. There may be the possibility that here 50 are male, 200 are females. There may be the possibility that 100 are male, 150 are females. There can be anything with respect to the sex. We are not talking about sex right now. What we are saying, that type of genetic combination obtained by the plant was this. Are you clear now?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, because if you talk about gender or if you talk about sex, then that is a different set of chromosome that has to be studied. Because out of all the set of chromosomes, suppose if in humans we say, out of 23 chromosomes, you are studying only one right now. Like this, other 22 are there. Then definitely other characters are there which are going to express themselves. That is what is happening with the pea plant. That out of all the characters and all the combinations, you took height, and what happened that when Mendel did this, then he got this type of combination naturally, and this is what he obtained in the first generation. And after the self-fertilization, self-pollination he allowed, he got this type of combination. So irrespective of gender, what he obtained, he was not studying gender at that time. What he was studying was only the height. Is it clear to you?
Yes, ma'am.
Fine. So all the plants of this particular population were tall. Here also he got tall. Here also he got tall plants. And here he got short plants. So the ratio in the F2 generation he obtained was 3:1. That is tall is to short. Out of that means if total number of 4 plants were there, he got 3 plants tall and 1 plant short. And you can relate this number to a number of plants if you are having. Out of 1,000, 700 plants can be tall and 300 plants can be short. Now it is clear to you.
Ma'am, sometimes both parents are short, but the child becomes tall.
Okay, fine. That we will go with the expression of the character that we will see. Okay, So that is what same question your classmate asked me just 5 to 10 minutes before. So let me solve this query. That there may be the possibility that both the parent are small. Now see, sometimes what happens that there may be the thing that if this type of combination is there in the parent, there may be the possibility that this capital T is not able to express itself. There may be the possibility because there are several reasons can work, either environment, either some type of hormones or anything else can be.
Ma'am, error in DNA copying.
Yes, there may be the errors also. There may be anything. You can take n number of reasons. And they, sometimes what happens that only this T expresses itself. And no matter if this genetic combination is obtained, there may be the possibility that parent is a short. There may be this thing. Okay. And suppose if you take father and mother, suppose, and both of them are having this type of combination. If we take father, if we take mother, okay, if you can have this, then definitely they are, the father is going to produce a sperm of these types. Okay, mother is going to produce ova of these types. Okay, and suppose they got a, they decide to have a child, and there may be the possibility of combining of these type of sperm and ova. Do you understand?
Yes, ma'am.
Then the child will definitely be a tall. Is it clear now?
Can't the parents have both the small T?
Yes, there may be the possibility that one of the parents, suppose if we take, let's take father as a short one. Mother is having this type of combination. Then father is going to produce these types of sperms. Is it clear? If these types of sperms are produced and ova is of this type, then the combination you are obtaining is this. See, if it is not how many children they are having. They may have one, they may have tons. Okay, so it doesn't make the difference to us. But the thing is, the type of combination of genes they are obtaining is of what type? There may be the possibility that child got this type of combination, suppose. Then in children, that particular kid, this gene is expressing, then the child become tall. If this type of condition is there, then definitely the kid is going to be a short. Because both of them are small. Then shortness is a genetic character he obtained from the parents. Okay. If this type of combination is there, capital T from mother and small t from father, but T expresses itself, then the child become tall. And here again, small t is obtained, then child become short. Now it is clear to you?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
See, you can take any type of combination. See, let me write down for father. Let me write down for mother. Okay. So, the father can have this type of combination. Father can have this type of combination. Father can have this type of combination too. Similarly, for the mother, there may be the possibility of these type of genetic pair she is having. There may be the possibility of this type. there may be the possibility of this type she must have. So the sperms produced by this type of combination, if father is having, then definitely all the sperms will be having this. If this type is there, then father must be having two types of sperms. Here only one type of sperms will be formed. Same thing happens with the ova. Mother can produce the ova of this type. She can produce the ova of this type. She can produce the ova of this type. Now you can select any combination of father and mother and you can produce this flowchart. You can take these two. You can take these two. You can take these two. Now go for this. You can take this as a father, this as a mother. Okay? You can take this as a father, this as a mother, this as a mother, this as a mother. So you can have these types of combinations. Now it is clear.
Ma'am, ratio will be 3:1. It is constant.
For pea plant, it was constant. Okay? For pea plant, what Mendel did was it was constant. 3:1. Now, see, what Mendel did was he repeated this experiment several times. And every time when he was doing this, he was obtaining F2 as 3:1. Okay? Now, see here, as we know that Mendel studied for the 7 characters, he also did this for color of flower. When he went for color of flower, then also what he obtained was this type of results. In color also he obtained in F2 generation 3:1. That means 3 for the dominating trait and 1 for the recessive trait. Is it clear to you now?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. And this what I said, you can understand the population by doing such things. Is it clear to you now?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
And girls?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Fine. So, if, see, I know right now you, there it's... visibly when I'm telling you and teaching you and you are doing this, I know it will be clear to you. But at the end of day, you may get confused with this. Again, there may be the possibility. So what you have to do is do this type of experiment or flowchart combination at least 1 to 2 times in a day for a week. Then you will understand the concept. Fine. Anything to be asked?
No, ma'am.
Fine. So what? This one?
Yes, ma'am. Okay, ma'am. Thank you, ma'am.
Okay. So this what I'm saying is for, I just made you understand that there may be the possibility of these type of combination in human population. Father can be of all these types, mother can be all or any one can be the possibility, and out of the whole population, any of them, the individual can be a parent of a future baby. So you can consider, you can take both of them as a combination. There may be the possibility that both of them are tall. Then definitely baby is going to receive only capital T from father and mother. So then baby is going to be a tall. Understood this?
Ma'am, when this yes, chapter ma'am. Will finish, how many classes will it take?
It will take as soon as you understand this. Right? So because
from 10th of September, our exams are starting, midterm exams.
Okay, fine. So no worries.
We have the production in this.
Fine. No worries. Don't worry regarding what you have not done. Just worry about what you have studied. Okay, you should be thorough with that much portion first of all. Okay, no worries. If it is not done, then don't have to rush behind the things which are not done, which are incomplete. Okay, but if you are sitting for exam, just remember that you should be thorough from which part you are good with it. And regarding reproduction, definitely I will plan one class for you, same day, the way you have given me in the last week. Okay, I will plan for it and we will do something about reproduction also.
Okay, ma'am. Ma'am, this Saturday.
Ma'am, every Friday will be battery class.
No. It's not for
ma'am,
every
Saturday.
No. It's not possible for every week. But I will plan. Let me see if I am clear on this week. Okay. Then only we can plan. Okay.
Okay, ma'am.
Fine. So that is what with the one character the Mendel did. This much is clear to you. Then we will go. You have a school right now?
Yes, ma'am. School classes are started.
Already started. Okay, fine. So, just do one thing. That do this much. Practice this much at your home for a one character. You can take another character also on for the pea plant. That is, suppose if you take color of seed or flower. Seed you can take. You can take yellow and green. Let me write down this. Green and yellow is a dominating one. So let's YY. And for green is small one. Sorry. You can choose these characters. Don't go for G, okay? It will make you confused because this is a recessive feature and this is a dominating feature. So, same type of alphabets has to be used. Capital Y, small y, okay? And you can go for shape of seed also. Round and wrinkled. Okay, for round take capital R and wrinkled take small r. It is clear to you?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, and do this, take this type of character and do this flowchart. You are getting this 3:1 or not? Just let me know that in the next class.
Okay, ma'am.
Fine. Do this, and if I will plan a class for this week, then I will definitely let you know. And
bye, ma'am.
Okay. Goodbye.
Bye, ma'am.
Goodbye, dear.
Thank you, ma'am.
Namaste.